artists in the Philippines using their craft to express dissent online. Last week, visual artist Kevin Raymundo posted a digital drawing of a person depicted as a fist, standing out in a crowd of bowed hands, depicting President Duterte's fist bump gesture. That digital art has blown up, with many artists adding their own fist avatars. And to tell us more about this online campaign, now known as Tumindig, is its creator, Kevin Raymundo, also known as Kevin Calbo, also known as TK. Good afternoon, Kevin. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Casey.
All right, let me ask you first, ilan ang nagawa mo in the past, how many days? Let's begin with how many you've done in the past 24 hours of these fist avatars.
Actually, yung mga fist avatars, hindi ako mismo yung gumagawa ng mga versions nila. Hmm. Sila mismo yung gumagawa noon. And they're the ones adding to the artwork itself.
Pero merong mga ibang artists that have decided to make for
yes.
these people.
Yes.
And we're going to talk to one of them later on in the program. But first, I want to ask you, what was that thought that brought this into life?
Kasi nung time na yun, ang daming balita na lumalabas na sobrang depressing, especially with the coming elections. Parang ang daming mga nagpaparamdam na mga politicians who want our vote. And para sa akin, I felt the need to para ilabas yung nararamdaman ko. Yun lang naman yung purpose ng artwork na yun, is to show what I'm feeling.
Nagulat ka ba?
Yes. Hindi, sobrang hindi ko siya in-expect na it would blow up na ganun kalaki.
Oo, kasi it was a personal expression
yes.
of dissent
yes.
and disgust.
Yes, yun lang yun.
Gaano ba ka-importante sa iyo bilang visual artist, Kevin, na ilagay sa sentro ng iyong art, no, ng iyong craft ang bayan, na hindi siya dapat lang basta art for art's sake, pero kailangan din ito makatulong sa pagmumulat ng kamalayan, pagmumulat ng mga natutulog pa or nagtutulog-tulugan, Kevin?
Para sa akin kasi, art is always political, whether you like it or not. Kumbaga, hindi siya just for aesthetics. Even if you choose not to participate dun sa political discourse, that in itself is staying silent. And when you stay silent, you are siding with the oppressors. Yeah.
Where did you get this? This fuel of yours to make art for the people, for the country?
Para sa akin, it's just a drive. Eh. Parang ito, this is what I am. Palaging yung nilalabas ko sa artwork ko is always coming from honesty.
Mm. And when you started getting all these hits and interests and likes dito sa sinimulan mong tumindig, aside from nagulat, ano pa yung naramdaman mo at ano yung naisip mo?
Naisip ko na meron pa pala tayong hope. Yan. Yun yung pinaka naramdaman ko. Kasi for the longest time, these past few years, and I'm sure a lot of people, ganun din yung nararamdaman nila na parang ang hopeless ng bansa natin sa mga nangyayari.
Hmm.
And nung nakita ko na merong sumama sa akin, dun ko naramdaman na, hindi pala ako nag-iisa. Madami pala tayo.
Parang napakaganda ng sinabi mo, Kevin, because it went full circle. You expressed,
yes.
you were hopeless.
Yes.
And because you were hopeless, you had to find a way to express that disgust and dissent, mm-hmm. only to be given hope by those who found hope in your art.
Yes, yes. Kaya right? sobrang nakakatuwa.
And one of those who is helping spread the fire is visual artist Jason Moss. And we're going to talk to him right now. Jason, welcome to the program. Thanks for joining us today.
Hi, good afternoon.
Ito ang alam ko na puyat. How many avatars did you work on in the past 24 hours?
Almost close to 100, and it's still adding up as we speak. So, yeah, I'm enjoying it.
You're enjoying it.
Thanks to, course.
And you're enjoying it so much. I mean, this is not new to you. You were an editorial artist for the Today newspaper. And when you were doing that, you had your fair share of bashers. But did that at all prepare you for the kind of bashing that you receive when you start making these avatars this time around, Jason?
It doesn't disturb me at all. Of course, merong halong kaba din, but I guess we're doing good. We're doing right. So the more death threats you get, I guess it means that we're doing a good job, right, Kevin?
Yes,
Kevin's doing a good job. So yeah. So,
well, what made you decide to take on the cost, Jason? And first of all, let me just backtrack a bit. When did you first see it? The movement start to come into a life of its own, and when did you start to think, I want to be part of this?
Well, personally, kasi I'm in grieving, and it does help me move forward if I help people. It's always been that way, so it feels good to do the right thing and push forward with it, with this collective dissent. So
I do want to take this moment to offer you my condolences on the passing of your father, and know that you and your father were really the best of friends, as he told me last night. So again, please accept my deepest condolences. And do you think that this is one thing that your father would have approved of? For sure.
For sure, yeah. Of course.
What do you think is the key here for other artists like you to be part of this movement? Why is it imperative for artists like yourself to be part of a movement like this?
Well, of course, we have to raise awareness, among other things, protesting against the anti-terror law. Of course, it does move me to at least spark change, like what Kevin's been doing. I'm kind of used to this as well, because I do belong to other groups. When I was younger, I was active helping out a lot of NGOs as well, environmental, education, etc. So it's really nothing new. I really involve myself in these things. And of course, drawing support for Kevin as well.
Yeah. Let me just go back to Kevin now. Kevin, naisip mo ba na tatawagin itong movement? Because that's what people are calling it now.
No, hindi talaga. Yung original post.
Siya, let me just add this, Kevin. At hindi lang siya tinatawag na movement, pero isa siyang movement na nangyayari sa gitna ng isang pandemya.
Yes. Sobrang overwhelming siya for me. Yung actual na piece na ginawa ko, wala siyang, hindi ko siya nilagyan ng context. It's just a bunch of fists na naka-fist bump and at the same time nakaluhod. So nagulat ako in a sense na na-connect ng mga tao kung ano yung iniisip ko making that artwork. Yeah.
Pagkatapos, kailan nangyari? Kwento mo sa amin yung konsepto. How did it come to this, from that artwork, na biglang dumami na tong mga kamao, at inisip mo ba na mula dun sa kamaong yun, magiging ganito ang magiging takbo, no? E ganito yung magiging buhay ng artwork mo.
Yung pinakaunang nag-join dun sa movement, kaibigan ko siya, si Alan Laycano, was commonly known as Kapitan Tambay. Isa din siyang komikero katulad ko. And nag-usa siya to add his avatar there. And then, nung nakita ko, ni-retweet ko lang siya. It's just a simple retweet. And from there, doon na siya nag-balloon into what it is now.
Of And you didn't think of this as sort of a pre-sona, di ba?
Hindi na, no, kasi ngayon, hindi talaga.
Sinasabi na that this is about, you know, the state of the final state of the nation address. But Jason, do you think that this is going to go beyond the final state of the nation address of the president?
Yes. It will.
And why do you think?
It's gaining a lot of traction. It's getting bigger than it is. And I won't be surprised if it's going to mutate into something bigger than it is.
And why do you think people can easily resonate? It's a very simple yes. artwork. Hindi ba,
Kevin? Yung mismo yung reason bakit mas gusto nila. Kasi hindi siya angry in a sense na violent, ganun.
Yeah.
Mas positive yung ini-imbibe ng art. And it's very simple. Madali siyang i-drawing. Madaming nagtatanong, nagpapadrawing sa akin kasi hindi sila artists. But they want to join the cause.
At saka, Jason, it embodies, I mean, alam naman natin yung simbolo ng kamao, di ba? Pero to be able to translate it in a very simple, non-violent, accepted form, yung without judgment right away, hindi ba? Mm-hmm. Parang ang, hindi ko alam, Jason, but I mean, you guys are the artists here. I'm just the one who appreciates it. But to be able to see that fist and feel that it's okay to have a dissenting opinion is already very powerful, especially in these times.
Yes.
I mean, we can't go outside. We can't do this on EDSA. Having a bunch of fists represent us is, I guess, it's safe. At least you're being counted. At least you're being heard. And of course, a lot of people want to be part of this, not because it looks good, not because, you know, oh, I'm going to have my own avatar. We do, and they do want to be part of this. It's not some novelty. Oh, it's so cute. Let me have one. You do have to understand why you want it, why you want to be there, and why you're joining this cause.
Yeah, and I think that's the beauty of dressing up these avatars as your own person.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi ba? Parang you're very, very connected
yes.
with that form of dissent. Tell us about the very interesting creations that you've done so far, Jason. Ano mga, and how does it go? Do they DM you? Do they tell you, I want to have this component again, or this is my picture, depict me as closest to this? How does it go?
Well, it started off as yung mga friends ko from FB. Uh-huh. Tapos parang dumami siya ng dumami, and then friends of friends will start messaging.
Mm-mm.
Actually, hindi naman siya ganun kadali kasi parang we're trying to establish an identity here. So I do have to look at their profile. Sometimes just to make it easier, I just ask them point blank, what do you want? And then, yeah, like, you want a bike or something? Actually, just to make this faster din, there are organizations already. Hindi siya pa isa-isang tao. Parang if you have a shirt of this org on the fist, then it mas madali siyang ikalat. Or universities have also approached me already. And I've yet to do it because that's a very long list. Kevin, help! And then going back to interesting ones, I don't know if you can see this.
Or maybe just describe it, kasi pa, I don't think we can capture it. But if you can.
Okay, well, this is Ben Cab. Yeah. And then ano pa bang interesting? Well, this is Kuya Boji from Batibot.
Amazing. And it does look, Kuya Bodri.
Yeah.
Diba? Oh. So si Ben Cab approached you, texted you, messaged you.
Si Annie, actually. Mm-hmm. Annie Sartu. So, yeah, and then she asked me to make one for Mang Ben. So of course, parang kasi Mang Ben then has met my father. I think they worked together at some point. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So parang family na rin. So you don't say no to that. In fact, I don't say no. I just take in whatever I can.
You gotta rest because we were texting each other late at night at magdo-drawing ka pa. Ito naman si Kevin. Kevin, what are your plans? You're gonna help out Jason here. It's enough. Or is it enough that you created this
movement? Oh, okay.
Actually, may plan kami na i-combine lahat ng mga entries into one big image. Mm. And then, ikakalat namin sa possibly offline, hindi na online, sa streets. Mm.
So Kevin, they're telling us to wrap up now because we still have a bunch of items to take care of. But your final thoughts and your final thoughts on this movement, as you said, has come, you know, it has a life of its own now. It's taken over Jason's life.
Okay. Ako, isang simpleng mamamayan na naglalabas ng kanyang saloobin sa pamamagitan ng pagguhit. I am using my talent and my platform to call out the Duterte administration for its cruel, unreasonable, and arbitrary use of power and control. I get a lot of questions lately kung tungkol saan yung artwork ko and if ako ba raw ay against sa government. And I think the better question to ask is, sawang-sawa na ang mga tao sa kapalpakan ng pang-aabuso, pagpapatahimik, pagpapakulong, pinabatay ang mga pangkaraniwang mamamayan, at sa gitna pa ng pandemya. Is the government against its own people? Kasi kung oo, ay dapat na itong palitan. Magparehistro tayo and let's vote them out in the coming elections. And that's it.
Thank you so much, Kevin, for joining us today. And Jason, your hope as well. What is your message to those who are not as brave as you, as Jason, as Kevin, and as brave as the others who continue to push and ask the questions that need to be asked? Your thoughts on that, Jason?
If you can't go on the streets, just use your fist, I guess.
Thanks a lot, Visual.
Kevin said most of what I wanted to say, but yeah.
Well, we get you. Thanks a lot. Jason Moss there, visual artist, and also Kevin Raymundo, also known as Kevin Calbo and TK. Guys, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Really appreciate it. You take care. Keep safe.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Kevin. Thank you, Carmina.